President Yoweri Museveni yesterday graced the commissioning of St. Kalule Ranga, Kigalama Catholic Parish, and the thanksgiving ceremony of the Deputy Speaker Thomas Tayeba's father, Daudi Bangirana, in Mitoma District. He lauded Tayeba for his dedicated contribution to the region.
Corruption, the accounting officers, be very strict. Don't allow anybody to mislead you, because you are the one responsible. If anything goes wrong, it will be you who will be held accountable.
In attendance were, among others, Speaker Anita Among, former Prime Ministers Amama Mbabazi and Dr. Ruhakana Rugunda, Minister of East African Affairs Rebecca Alitwala Kadaga. Also present was Uganda's Prison Service Boss Dr. Johnson Mbibasheja, Vision Group CEO Don Wanyama, as well as businessmen Dr. Sudiru Pareria and Hamis Chigundu.
When I conceived the idea, I said, no, the Lord has given me so much. Me and my wife, we can easily build it. Then I told my sister, the speaker. When I told her, she's like, you're lying. She says, I'm going to support you. I won't mention how much people supported me with. King Susa Mrenga said, no, you can't do it alone. So they went and conspired with a few friends.
Addressing congregants, Among lavished her deputy with praise before promising to hand her deputy Themas Tayeba speakership in 2031. Her comments come on the back pedal of calls by activists urging her to throw in the towel.
You move around trying to destroy the country and saying Anita must resign. Resign and go where? I am still around. Silence in the church today said I still have one term to serve. When I finish serving my 5 years in the next term, then I will give it to my young brother, Thomas.
St. Kalule Ranga, Kigalama Catholic Parish was constructed by Tayeba at a tune of 2.7 billion shillings in honor of his grandmother, Businje Juliet. Most of the funds, according to Tayeba, were raised by friends. Karamoja sub-region leaders held a special joint council meeting to pay tribute to the former Moroto Municipality MP, Simon Peter Alipe, who died in a road accident last Tuesday. A special session was held on Saturday at Boma Grounds in Naitakwai, Moroto Municipality. According to the NRM Secretariat, members of the party's Central Executive Committee, which he belonged to, MPs and other dignitaries also attended the session.
And I vividly remember that Honorable Alipe Simon Peter stood firmly on the idea of functionalizing the regional status of Karamoja.
Our prayer, as we pray for KDA to be reinstated, we request government to actually bring back all the staffs of Karamoja, Ministry of Karamoja in the region.
Karamoja has very few representatives, only 26. We still need more representatives by creating more districts, by creating more constituencies.
Leaders came from the region's 9 districts of Kotido, Kabong, Karenga, Nabilatuk, Abim, Moroto, Napak, Amdat, and Nakapiripiti to honor Alipe's contributions towards the area's development. On Friday, President Museveni, who is the NRM national chairperson, described the former veteran politician as a martyr who died while fighting for the development of Karamoja. He pledged to support the children of the deceased with the house and school fees.
Study. We shall pay for them until they finish their education. Then my staff, my state house control is here to make sure that the Alapere's family get a Kasimora house in Kampala here.
According to the statement released by the Busoga East Police, Alipe was killed instantly in a hit-and-run accident along Iganga Tilingi Highway. This occurred around 1 a.m. at Bukona and involved a Toyota V8 motor vehicle, number UAP-787Q, which he was driving. Uganda rower Kathleen Noble got her second Olympic Games outing with a fifth-place finish in heat one of the women's single sculls event at the National Olympic Stadium in France on Saturday. The result was a replica of her debut performance at the 2020 Tokyo Olympics in Japan, where she finished in the same position in heat two of the same event. She finished with over 2,000 meter distance behind Australia's Tara Rigney, Spain's Virginia Diaz-Rivas, South Africa's Paige Badenhorst, and Islamic Republic of Iran's Fatmech, who finished first, second, third, and fourth, respectively. More Ugandans are expected to take stage on Friday, including swimmers Gloria Muzito and Jesse Sengozi, as well as two countries' medal hopefuls, Joshua Cheptegei and Jacob Kiplimo, alongside Martin Magengo Kiprotich. In another turn of events, the first training session for trial athletes was scrapped yesterday due to pollution in the River Seine. Following a meeting on the water quality and tests, a joint decision was taken to cancel the swimming part of the triathlon orientation. The River Seine was declared clean enough for swimming in tests from mid-July, but doubts remained as to whether the waters would be fit for competition. Organizers blamed rain in recent days and said they were confident water quality would improve enough before the triathlon competition is due to start on July 30th.